We're down at the CYC with owner of Kia Loa 2, Paddy. Paddy, tell me about your preparation leading up to this race. You've done the Rolex Sydney Hobart last year. What's different this year?
The major thing that's different this year is a new mast. Last year we broke the boom in the race. We still finished the race and did quite reasonably by our standards. But when we did a big survey of everything when we got back to Sydney, we had a bit of a think about it, my brother and I, who's co-owner. And we decided that a new mast was in the offing. And so we got hold of Johnny Denton from Wales Spars. You know, many Sydney Hobart racers will know John. And he and his team designed up a whole new spar that's very much the same as the old one in terms of the geometry and the layout and all the rest of it. But just some very clever thinking from John in it. It's pretty much the same weight, but just so much easier to use and obviously new. So yeah, that's the major thing. The one problem is that while we did talk about this mast in March, it didn't actually go in until the beginning of December. So we haven't had a huge amount of preparation. We did our 24-hour race and we've done some good sailing.
Yeah.
And I guess such was the care that they've designed it that it's slotted in perfectly and it's brilliant. So it's really good.
Oh, beautiful. Kia Loa 2 is the oldest boat in this year's Rolex Sydney Hobart Yacht Race fleet. So tell me about the crew on board and what the family connections are, because you've got so many of them.
Well, the crew's probably almost the oldest crew in the race as well. I mean, I think something like 204, 205 Sydney Hobart races between us, chiefly all done by Lindsay May, though. But, we've got, my brother and I is a relationship. We've got Genevieve and Ian, who are husband and wife. And then we've got Randy and Jack. And Randy's from the Royal Yacht Club of Tasmania and his son Jack on board. So there's always some links there. And there's also quite a few of Brinda Bella boys, George Snow's family, if you like, inverted commas, in terms of a lot of us cut our teeth on big boat ocean racing with George on the Brinda Bella.
Yeah, so we were also talking earlier, you and I, about going bananas. Can you tell me about that?
Well, one of the crew, again, from Brinda Bella days, a chap called Jeff Beaton, his daughter, Juliet, has set up this rather innovative campaign to reduce waste. We waste a lot of farm produce because we only pick the perfectly shaped stuff, and that's probably, I guess, less than 20% of what they produce. So she's come up with a campaign called Going Bananas to try and encourage people that, you know, shape isn't actually really important, it's the taste. So we're supporting Juliet and we'll have a sticker on the boom for Going Bananas.
Perfect. So just quickly tell me about what it's going to be like on board Kia Loa 2 heading down to Hobart. What are you going to be eating? Who's going to be making the coffee, etc.?
Right. Well, life on board Kia Loa is quite different to some of these boats, obviously. It's a lot more comfortable below, but she does lean over more. She was built long and thin like the boats used to be of that era. So inside in the galley, there's a gimbaled table, which is very important when you're serving food. And particularly given we have very, very good food on board, we're expecting to have at least one roast dinner during the trip. We generally get cooked breakfasts. The food is excellent, and that's Grant Chessels, Grunter as he's known. He's a very, very good sailor, but got very fed up eating rubbish food on the way to Hobart, so he's made a bit of an art form of it. So there was always a bit of fun, and no doubt there'll be a tot of whiskey as we go around Tasman Island, and that's a George Snow tradition.
Perfect. Well, it sounds like it's going to be a great trip. What are you planning for after the Rolex Sydney Hobart Yacht Race?
Next year's a really big year. Obviously the 75th Rolex Sydney Hobart race, but it's also the 50th running of the Transpac race. Kia Loa did the Transpac race in 67 and 71. And so we're going to sail from here in about middle of April and sail to Long Beach, California, do the Transpac race, and then come back and do the 75th Rolex Sydney Hobart race. So it's going to be a big year next year.
Perfect. Well, sounds action-packed. Thanks for chatting to us today, Paddy, and good luck for the race.
Thank you very much indeed.